Welcome to Lab 360, where we bring you the best videos from the world of astronomy. Astronomers, scientists, and common folk like us can spend decades debating the status of objects in our solar system. Is little Pluto a planet? What will become of Saturn now that it's losing its rings? Well, the truth is, every planet in every solar system got the short end of the stick. The winners of the cosmic game are the nomads, the wanderers, the rogue planets. Our galaxy is full of stars and planets. Typically, there is at least one star per planet, wherein the planet orbits around that star. The Milky Way has a few hundred billion stars, giving us therefore a few hundred billion planets orbiting those stars. And for every planet, there is at least one rogue planet, marking its journey in space. So, what is a rogue planet? Rogue planets are cosmic objects that move freely, unattached and single in space. They do not orbit any particular star, and have masses very similar to the planets in our solar system. By virtue of their small size and dim light, they are extremely hard to detect. They only glow weakly in the infrared, from any internal heat they may have. More reasons for them to be called rogues. And more reasons for them to have remained undetected, and a mystery for astronomers. Well, until now. In a stunning discovery, on December 22, 2021, a team of astronomers discovered at least 70 new rogue planets in our galaxy. Under normal circumstances, a planet not in proximity to its parent star would have no source of illumination, and hence difficult to detect. But these planets were glowing, and hence identifiable. Using data from several European Southern Observatory, ESO, telescopes, and other facilities spanning 20 years, astronomers and scientists took advantage of the fact that, in the few million years after their formation, these relatively young planets were still hot and glowing, allowing them to be discovered by sensitive cameras on large telescopes. The team measured tiny motions, colors, and luminosities of millions of sources in a large section of the space, the Upper Scorpius. They measured the points of light in optical and near-infrared wavelengths in, and combined the measurements with the movement they detected. This allowed them to identify the faintest objects in the sky, the rogue planets. They found that many of the planets have masses comparable to Jupiter's in a star-forming region close to our Sun, located within the Scorpius and Ophiuchus constellations. This region of sky lies 420 light-years away from Earth. The detection of so many rogue planets also begs the question, how did these rogue planets come to be? By studying the newly found rogue planets, astronomers are trying to find clues to this mystery. Some scientists believe rogue planets were formed from the collapse of a gas cloud that was too small to form of a star. Others believe that they may have been kicked out from a solar system similar to ours. If this is true, then the possibility of there being a host of Earth-sized rogue planets journeying through the cosmos is very high. This discovery of 70 rogue planets has been a monumental step in allowing us to better understand the origins of these elusive cosmic nomads. For example, we have the OTS-44, a potential rogue planet, 11 times the mass of Jupiter, and 554 light-years away. The debate on whether it is a rogue planet, or an object known as the brown dwarf, is still on. On the other hand, the oval 2019 BLGO551, although is the size of Earth, could either be a rogue or a regular planet, on an extremely wide orbit from its parent star. However, what has excited astronomers and scientists the most, is the speculation of rogue planets harboring life. We have seen, that although the rogue planets are neither illuminated, nor warmed by stars, they do have internal heat. And where there is heat, there is likelihood of water. Which is what we need to live and harbor life. Fancy a trip to a rogue planet? Let us know in the comments below and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360, because in astronomy, we trust. Welcome to Lab 360, where we bring you all the latest happenings from the world of astronomy. NASA is preparing to bring its Capstone spacecraft to launch soon and travel to the moon, and it will provide a massive stepping stone for the Artemis mission soon. The spacecraft is only the size of a microwave oven, and it weighs around 55 pounds only. Its main goal is to demonstrate an experimental orbit for the coming NASA Gateway, a lunar outpost for its future missions. capstone is a CubeSat that NASA turned into a spacecraft that is only 55 pounds in mass and takes on the size of a microwave oven. According to NASA, the team is preparing to send a small satellite that will help the company determine massive information for its future Artemis mission. Capstone, which stands for Cislunar Autonomous Positioning System, Technology Operations, and Navigation Experiment, will help the company determine more about how the moon's orbit works. The Capstone satellite would be the first spacecraft that would look into this and bring answers to NASA that will help its future mission to the moon. The space agency is preparing to set up a lunar outpost on the moon in its upcoming mission towards it, but it would not send its spacecraft right then and there. It will focus on the capstone that would bring answers to the lunar orbit before it goes on for the real deal. NASA's Gateway is the lunar outpost venture of the company for the upcoming Artemis moon mission, and it would help in setting up camp for the future. NASA is not shying away from showcasing many of the technology that will come for the Artemis moon mission, and it will focus on bringing the public much information about all things regarding the upcoming venture. One of the latest ventures of NASA is the wet dress rehearsal of the Space Launch System, SLS, rocket bound for the moon. The company is also focusing on transportation methods that will be available while on the lunar surface, and not only a vehicle that will take them from the planet to its natural satellite. A planned electric vehicle is coming to replace the 1980s Astro van, and it is with EV manufacturer Canoo to fulfill the car's design and technology come to its mission. Of course, NASA is also preparing its astronaut candidates for the Artemis mission, as it would bring the first woman to the moon. Many preparations are set in place to ready the upcoming mission, as it would be a significant one, as it would be the return to the moon after several decades since the last. Capstone will help set up a massive advancement on the future moon mission, and it will do so despite it being a small spacecraft. Before Gateway launches for its purpose, the Capstone will provide an experimental test on its orbit. We cannot wait for the Artemis mission to kick off. About you? Drop in your comments to let us know, and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360, because in space we trust. Welcome to Lab 360, where we give you all the latest news from the world of astronomy. For years, astronomers have known that the Earth orbits the Sun and that the Sun slowly revolves around the enigmatic center of our galaxy. Until now, the Milky Way's core has been only speculated about by analyzing its gravitational impact on its surroundings in space. Astronomers have long questioned what lies at the center of the Milky Way galaxy. Decades of calculations and evidence suggest that at the center of our home galaxy, there lies a supermassive black hole about 4 million times more massive than our Sun. Humans, on the other hand, have never seen it. Is that going to change soon? We believe so. Scientists have released the first ever image of the supermassive black hole that lurks there, providing a radically new perspective on our home galaxy. The historic image of Sagittarius A, taken by a global telescope array, known as the Event Horizon Telescope, EHT, indicates a black hole in the Milky Way's heart, which is feasting on hydrogen gas. The Event Horizon Telescope first made headlines in 2019, when it captured the first image of Messier 87's black hole. But this new discovery has gotten scientists bouncing with joy in their seats. The EHT observed Sagittarius A, the Milky Way's supermassive black hole, at the same moment it obtained the data that generated that image. Sagittarius A, on the other hand, proved more difficult to photograph than M87. For one, the EHT's submillimeter radio waves are absorbed by Earth's water-laden atmosphere. Furthermore, in the 27,000 light-years between us and Sagittarius A, gas and dust have scattered the submillimeter wavelengths and obscured the image. Finally, M87's black hole has a voracious appetite and seems bright because it is eating a lot of gas, whereas the material flow into Sagittarius A is considerably more feeble, resulting in a much fainter object. It wasn't simple to capture this image. It took years to perfect the photograph and validate their suspicions. Black holes are the densest things in the universe, and their gravity is so strong that not even light can escape from within. The telescope can detect light in the form of radio waves emitted by hot gas swirling near the event horizon. The stuff within the black hole's immediate vicinity feeds it, whether it is gas clouds, asteroids, or even stars that go too close and are ripped apart by gravitational tides. Sagittarius A, on the other hand, is starving. The hot gas surrounding Sagittarius A is crucial for accretion studies because it will tell us how much material is captured from the nearby stars. But currently, NASA doesn't have this vital information and can't determine as to why this black hole is starving. The event horizon of Sagittarius A is 51.8 microarcade seconds across the sky, according to the latest photograph. The researchers called the image as the biggest test of Einstein's theory of general relativity ever made, emphasizing that the theory passed with flying colors. It's an ideal setting for studying how gravity behaves in the vicinity of a gigantic black hole. Our explanations for the turbulence in the gas ring are less certain, because M87's black hole is far larger than Sagittarius A, it takes days for changes to appear, but Sagittarius A is much smaller, and the brightness of the ring can vary in minutes as material whips around it. Apart from giving photographic proof that Sagittarius A exists, the new image also supports the hypothesis that the supermassive black hole at the center of the Milky Way is rotating. It also allowed EHT researchers to determine the black hole's orientation in relation to Earth. To reach this groundbreaking result, more than 300 international scientists, support staff, and 8 radio observatories from around the world collaborated together. The EHT team announced that tens of millions of photos from its global network of radio telescopes were combined to create the final image that was shared with the globe today. The team intends to share more photographs and videos of other black holes following their pioneering new discovery of the Milky Way's core. The team has already given us a new viewpoint on the universe, validating Einstein's theories in the process, and all that remains is for them to keep going in the same direction. These are exciting times for science. 2022 has been delightful so far. Well done, NASA. What do you guys have to say? Drop in your comments below and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360 for all the latest news from the world of astronomy.